The Syrian conflict is in its fifth year, making Jordan home to more than 1.3 million Syrian refugees, many struggling with trauma and the psychological costs of war. With fewer than 100 psychologists in Jordan, doctors and social workers are struggling to fill the mental health care gap. University of California Berkeley journalism students bring us this story. It's narrated by Lacey Jane Roberts.
The war in Syria led Nisreen Katbi to flee her home country 4 years ago. Now she runs a center in Amman, Jordan, that cares for refugees fleeing from Syria. They're recovering from the trauma of war. Suryat Across Borders is a home away from home for refugees suffering from both physical and emotional disabilities. They get rehabilitative care and live full-time at the center, all free of charge.
This is where they have their physical therapy training.
Nisreen and her staff care for a rotating group of 30 men, women, and children. The residents can stay at the center until they're rehabilitated, after which many return to their families in war-torn Syria. Nisreen sees people with amputations, spinal cord injuries, and head traumas. But she says the injuries aren't only physical.
They face some frightening situations like the bombing, the killing, losing their limbs, or had these severe injuries.
But Suryat Across Borders has no full-time mental health professionals on staff. So when a mental health training project run by a group of California-based doctors came to Amman, Nisreen signed up.
Today we will talk about post-traumatic stress disorder.
Dr. Saad Shaker leads CPR, or care program for refugees. At first, CPR's goal was to give direct mental health care to Syrian refugees. But after seeing the overwhelming number of people needing help, they instead began offering mental health first aid training to clinicians, counselors, teachers, and even legal consultants, anyone who works with refugees.
Well, being a physician, I'm a humanitarian. So seeing all the devastation going on, it's like I want to have an impact in a positive way.
Dr. Atef Al-Qasim is CPR's on-the-ground partner and training manager for the Nur al-Hussein Foundation's Institute for Family Health. He was eager to partner with Dr. Shaker after seeing an increase of refugees needing quality mental health care.
The goal of the training is to have anyone dealing with refugees to be able to provide psychological first aid. 19% of people we see have been victims of torture. We also see PTSD, depression, anxiety. All of them need immediate treatment.
Dr. Al-Qasim says that it's hard to provide individual treatment with so many patients and so few professionals. So he's encouraging caretakers and mental health workers to apply group therapy. At their field clinic in the Zaatari refugee camp, the counselors with the Nur al-Hussein Foundation try to see as many people as possible in group therapy. The camp is one of the biggest in the world, home to 70,000 refugees. Amsanat al-Badi works as a counselor in the camp, where he says he confronts mental health stigmas.
We have a mobile team which makes visits to refugees to talk about the need of psychosocial counseling because the psychological support is necessary.
Once individuals start coming to group therapy, counselors help them cope with trauma and loss.
Common trauma we see is loss trauma. I ask them to remember their happy memories and encourage positive thinking about the future.
Back in Amman, Doctors Without Borders is treating refugees who've been physically disfigured from Syria, Yemen, and Iraq. Dr. Gwena Laganis manages the hospital's mental health program. She says there's no way to predict how people will react to a traumatic event.
On a psychological point of view, there is no rules. It's not a mathematical equation. Most of the people will develop symptoms such as depression or anxiety disorder and a small percentage of PTSD.
Children especially can be affected by the trauma of war. Talha Al-Ali is a pediatric counselor. He works with young victims to rebuild trust.
They start at the beginning to have these small social networks while playing or while doing activities together, like a child will start to adapt again with building relationships, and especially to build a trustful relationships. But to protect them from the trauma, no one will be able to protect them, while they are living in a war.
After the training, Nisreen Katbi says she'll be able to provide better care for the patient residents.
I've learned how to deal with certain cases, like if he is having constant nightmares, or if he is aggressive in a certain way, or depressed.
Dr. Ganes agrees that while this training is useful, much more is needed.
It's useful, but it's not enough. On a humanitarian point of view, we need to train a lot of people in a short time.
CPR hopes to return to Amman once a year, and Nisreen hopes she'll eventually be able to train her whole staff.
This is the most important thing for us to do. We have to raise an awareness about how to deal with the victims of war.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Lacey Jane Roberts in Amman, Jordan.